Yo everybody, what's going on? This is Keegan from K-Man Reviews. If you enjoy this review, make sure you hit that like and the subscribe button. And if you have any opinions at all you would like to share, make sure to leave them down in the comment section. Vic Mensa, V-Tape. Vic Mensa, Chicago rapper, singer, and center of a lot of controversy over the past few years. Especially with that whole dissing of X after he passed, to which he received universal backlash afterwards. But since then, he's still remained fairly active in the music world, with the Hooligans EP and a brief stint in the genre of punk rock a la 93 Punks. But now it seems like he's back in the world of hip-hop, with this new EP, mixtape, album, whatever it is, V-Tape. After reviewing and not minding the autobiography back in 2017, it sure was interesting to see Vic go down this genre whirlpool that he did. And while I thought that Hooligans EP was one of the best things he's done in a long time, maybe he's returning with a vengeance with this project. So what do I think of V-Tape? Let's find out as I review it, track by track. Since there were really no singles, we'll just start at the beginning of the track list with the opener Vendetta, which is a very gripping and enticing opener. These opening lyrics right here alone, even if they aren't delivered with as much energy as they could be, this shows that the Vic I remembered from 2017 is still here and hungry too. Nice bit of clever wordplay scattered throughout the track as well, very clean rapping, and this instrumental mainly being just the deep bass, but also the trap drum in there added for that extra little flavor. Kinda wish the two verses here mingled a little bit more. They are separated by the instrumental break near the middle of the track, but aside from that, these lyrics about coming back. A lot of name drops, a lot of braggadocio. Even after all this time, he sounds confident like he's got a lot to prove. Great opening number, really sets into motion how this project is going to be. Machiavelli featuring Aaron Allen Kane continues the train of confidence on the very first bar where he raps about he's back to reclaim his throne, and arguably it kinda works. Yet again, a very captivating flow through the tune with these grand cymbal smashes and horns. It feels very prestigious all around. Aaron Allen Kane has a wonderful voice, and that's portrayed here on the outro of the track where the energy dies down to a near halt, as she's basically vocally riffing, but it still sounds great. Again, great wordplay, sweeping confidence, and grandiose at the same time, fantastic track. Dirt on My Name is a pure banger. There's always gotta be one of them on every Vic Mensa project. This beat just goes so hard with its skittering yet punchy trap drums and the heavy bass taps as well. Vic's flow, however, is easily the most exciting thing here. It's just so fluid and consistent and clear. What I'm not the biggest fan of, unfortunately, is that the outro goes on for about 35 seconds out of the cut's 3-minute long runtime. I mean, the track really didn't need this. But these lyrics and the title alone, yeah, it's not surprising what he's rapping about. The controversy he's been subject to over the past years. Regardless, still a great song. X Games featuring Snow Allegra is a much slower track as a whole, almost bordering on R&B, with these synths being as airy as they are alongside the moody bass and trap drums. Snow Allegra's voice is easily the best part of the track. They're so soft and delicate, almost pillowy to an extent. Vic still retains his confidence from previous tracks, even though he tries to rap as the more vulnerable type here, kinda sounding a little bit off as a whole, but his flow is okay, maybe a little bit generic. Lyrically, it's about this problematic relationship, and there's very little openness and trust to be had. It is one of the more lackluster songs here. I could take it or leave it. Bethlehem / SC Freestyle is split up into two parts, so we'll start with the Bethlehem section, which goes on for about half the track, which features this very lavish production, accented by the soulful background singers. Vic's flow is front and center, very dominant as he raps about racial injustice, prejudice, and incarceration. Then we get the SC Freestyle, which is a very sudden transition into this much darker and sinister beat, but his presence still holds very firm as he hammers in a little bit more about the types of issues mentioned on Bethlehem, but focused more on his hometown of Chicago and what happens there. The juxtaposition here sonically is very well executed, and the track as a whole gets my recommendation. Too Honest featuring St. John is a painfully vulnerable and, as the title suggests, honest track, which opens up with Mikel Carter and her beautiful voice contrasted with the distorted bass and Vic's performance. The instrumental simmers down pretty far with the light percussion and angelic background support, and St. John's chorus is just wonderful. There's a good reason why he's on the rise as of right now. It's very chill. And while Vic's verse is nice, the second verse demands all the attention as the percussion dissipates as he pours his heart and soul, almost getting to the point where he breaks down mid-performance, as he raps about his depleting mental state recently. It's almost harrowing to listen to, and a definite standout on here. Beautiful song, gets my recommendation as well. And finally, the closer Rebirth featuring BJ the Chicago Kid, Peter Cottontail, and Darius Scott is a full 5-minute conclusion to this project, which starts with BJ's chorus, and he's got a very tame voice, which is fitting as he precedes Vic, who comes in with his usual swagger and flow. But rapping about his father and how he underwent surgery the day he dropped his album and was left paralyzed. But then on the second verse here, he goes on to address his controversies, apologizing for dissing X, and it almost sounds like a rebirth of himself. The final moments of this track are glorious, though with this cleansed beat singing about coming back from the dead and flying away. It's a beautiful closer and a good song to boot as well. Overall, this Vic Mensa project truly feels like the rebirth of his career. Returning to his rap roots that initially brought him success with the XXL feature and all the projects he's released in the genre, some wonderful wordplay, focused, consistent flow, and even some bangers to top it off, it may just be one of his best projects to date. And that's why I'm feeling a 7.5 out of 10. Well guys, hope you enjoyed that review. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.